With spring finally here, our turf grasses are waking up and coming out of dormancy. We're actually standing on a zoysia lawn here at the LSU AgCenter Botanic Gardens Ornamental and Turf Research Facility, and I'm here with Dr. Eric DeBoer. He's the Assistant Professor for Turf Grass Management at the LSU AgCenter. So, Eric, can you just lay us a good foundation? Tell us exactly how we're supposed to be fertilizing our turf grass now that it's actually come out of dormancy.
Yeah, before going out to buy fertilizer, you're going to want to know two things. Number one, the total area of the lawn that you're going to be fertilizing. And then two would be the type of turf grass that's in your lawn.
So what are some of the risks if we put down fertilizer too soon in the year?
Yeah, putting fertilizer down too soon can result in maybe some disease issues. Mm-hmm. You could actually be feeding some of the winter annual weeds in your lawn. Mm-hmm. And then a turf grass that isn't fully growing could be putting on green succulent growth, and a late frost could damage some of that newly green tissue.
And that would set it back even further for the normal spring greenup, correct?
Correct.
Okay. So, Eric, now when we go to buy our actual fertilizer, what kind of formulation should I look for?
Yeah, when going to purchase a fertilizer, I would look for something that is higher in nitrogen and has less phosphorus.
And I know that's important to consider because we are having too much phosphorus runoff into our waterways, and we need to be cognizant of that.
That's correct. And also, nitrogen is probably the most important nutrient to get out in the spring anyways.
That makes a lot of sense. So now that I know what formulation to use, how do I figure out what rate to apply at?
You're going to need to know the brand of your spreader.
Okay.
And also be able to look on a table on the back of the fertilizer bag that corresponds to different brands of fertilizer spreaders. And then each spreader should have its own dial that you set to, and that information will be on the bag of fertilizer.
I think you've got a foundation set for us to actually have a beautiful green lawn in the spring, so we appreciate that. For Get It Growing, I'm Jason Stagg with Dr. Eric DeBoer for the LSU AgCenter.